Let's get some more practice working with data frames. You downloaded an R script earlier and saw how we can save our work and run R code from it. For your next task, you're going to download an RMD file and run code in it. You can download the RMD file from the link in the instructor notes. The file will look something like this. Notice how this file is slightly different from the file that you saw before. An R script can only have R code and comments. This file, however, the RMD file, allows us to do so much more. It's an R Markdown document, or RMD. Now, you might be wondering what R Markdown is, and basically, it's a simple formatting language that lets us author web pages. If you want to know all that you can do with Markdown, go to Help, and then go to Markdown Quick Reference. This would bring up the documentation for Markdown, and you can scroll through some of the examples and the formatting. We've also included a video in the instructor notes that will go through Markdown. So far, this file only contains text that will be formatted using Markdown. Let's add some R code to this. We can do this by clicking on Chunks and then going to Insert Chunk. Now, if you're friendly with a keyboard, you can use the shortcut Command-Option-I. There's many other shortcuts in here, and you can see them here in this menu. Here, I've added some code to see what this dataset is. This is the cars dataset that also comes with R, and it contains 50 observations of speeding and stopping distances for cars in the 1920s. I'm going to add this text as the title to this document, so that way it's more descriptive of my file. I'll also run the str command on this data frame so that way I can see what's inside of it. It looks like I have two variables, speed and distance, which are measured in miles per hour in feet. Not only can we run R code and get the output from these files, we can also embed images. This plot function comes with the base graphics package in R, but don't worry learning more about it. We'll be using the ggplot2 package, which is the powerful graphics language in the coming lessons. When I run this code, I get a simple plot of speed versus distance. Now, what's really amazing about this document is that we can click the knit HTML button. This will generate a web page that includes both content as well as the output of any embedded R code. This simple button allows us to easily share and publish our work. That's enough about RMD files. Let's have you work in one now. Download the RMD file if you haven't already, and run and write code when you're prompted to do so. At the end of the file, you'll come across a question. I want you to answer that question for this next quiz, and then you can continue on with the rest of the lesson. Good luck and have fun.